Being told that you or someone in your family has muscular dystrophy can be absolutely terrifying. I mean, especially something called like facioscapulohumeral muscular dystrophy, FSHD. I mean, what is that? Never even heard of it. I mean, I know I had never heard of it until a patient introduced me to it. But we've all heard of muscular dystrophy. At least my generation, and you know, maybe a few older, grew up with MDA telethons, Jerry's Kids. You know, these are young kids in wheelchairs, and really, really heartbreaking stories because muscular dystrophy, is a fatal disease. Well, Duchenne muscular dystrophy, which affects exclusively, pretty much exclusively young boys, is. But FSHD is very different. Okay, in fact, there's 9 different types of muscular dystrophy, and FSHD, despite the fact that many people haven't heard of it, is really the most prevalent of the muscular dystrophies, meaning there are more people alive today with FSHD than any of the other muscular dystrophies. There's more than 40,000 people in the U.S., okay? And this actually number is probably a lot higher. There's at least 1 million people in the world that have FSHD, okay? In fact, a lot of people don't even know this, but the Muscular Dystrophy Association, Paul Cohen, who founded that, they're actually FSHDers, okay? They just didn't know it at the time, and it was founded, and for reasons we don't get into, it became very DMD-focused. But actually, FSHD was the founding disease for the MDA. And so it's very important that people learn about these different muscular dystrophies, and particularly about FSHD and what sets FSHD apart. And we have some of that here on this page and throughout the site. And there's a lot of more in-depth information online, and hopefully your clinician can give you more information about FSHD. But on the other hand, you do have to take some of this into your own hands and do some of your own research. I've had several people tell me that their clinicians told them they couldn't possibly have muscular dystrophy because they're a woman or because they're over 30. And again, for Duchenne muscular dystrophy, that's true. But I mean, seriously? I mean, there's 9 types of muscular dystrophy, and there's adult onsets. There's multiple adult onsets. There are limb-girdle muscular dystrophies and Emery-Dreifuss muscular dystrophies that are also adult onset. Okay, so it's not just FSHD. It's the most common. But there are some characteristic features. Oftentimes, there's some weakness in your face that probably doesn't send you to the doctor, but retrospectively, you might notice, I've never been able to whistle or sip through a straw, close your eyes at night. Typically, what sends you to a neurologist is an ability to reach something off a shelf, or something, not able to comb your hair or blow dry your hair or something like that. The change is actually something that's important in your life. So what's important to know, though, is that not everybody with FSHD has these symptoms, has facial weakness, and not everybody with facial weakness has FSHD. So we really need to get a proper diagnosis, which is a combination of a proper clinical evaluation and genetic testing, or in this case, we can also do some research testing, just to really make sure that you're on the right path. So here you can find some information about FSHD. There are a lot of other sources for clinical information about FSHD that can be helpful as well. And it's just very important that you take this into your own hands and learn about yourself and your family's disease, if it is in fact FSHD, and so that you can be empowered to make proper decisions about yourself. So I hope you learned something here, and please feel free to ask us questions anytime. We're always happy to respond to anybody who reaches out. Thanks.